All right, yo, it's your boy Raven, or BT, coach of the Destined Lucarios, and I am back for week 6 of the SSDL. So this week, I actually faced my boy EduRufus of the Sao Paolos Dragonites, and like I said in my last video, he hasn't been doing too well. His team, on paper, I wasn't scared of, but then prepping for it, it was really scary to prep for, because he has so many big mega threats. Like, all of his Pokemon are pretty much threats here, aside from Audino. Audino is just fat. And, man, so basically, I brought him into our group of friends, and he pretty much had a stellar first season, but, like, he hasn't really been able to get that form back. It's been a while, so this time around, I'm going to show my team builder. So week 6, we got Manaphy, Zeraora, Type Null, Gligar, Zatu, and Girder. Girder, Luki's gym teacher, is back again. So my plan with Manaphy, as you can see, it was defensive as heck. Energy Ball, Scald, Rest Talk. It was for Infernape mainly. What else did he have? Infernape, Mega Gyarados. Basically, those two things were pretty scary. So I need a physical mon that could eat hits from them, like Manaphy, because water resists fire. We already know that shit. Water resists water, like clear as day. And Mega Gyarados wasn't gonna do too much to this. For my next mon, I had Zeraora. Again, a more special defensive spread. I had the speed creeped for Infernape. And this was mainly for the Rotom Mo, because I did not want him Volt Switching around, to be honest. And it could take a hit from Leaf Storm decently. And I have Thunderbolt for obvious reasons, just as like a general attack. Hidden Power Ice, mainly for the Rotom Mo. I didn't really want to run Toxic because, well, actually I could have ran Toxic, but he has so many mons immune to Toxic, and he has a Heal Bell user, so it wasn't that great. Hidden Power Ice also worked for Zygarde 10% in case like I catch him on a switch or something. So that was the plan for Zeraora. Type Null, classic fat Type Null Masked Reindeer, mainly for Zygarde 10% for the Dust Noir. That's why I have Shadow Claw, Swords Dance. Basically Swords Dance up to do as much as it can to anything, actually. Jirachi, Zygarde, Dust Noir, but it kind of gets walled by Audino, to be honest. Dang, I did not see that through. But yeah, my next mon, Gligar, also for the Zygarde, because I know if Zygarde gets out of hand, that's gonna be nasty. And actually, Gligar kind of comes in clutch. It's also good for the Jirachi, like, if it doesn't have Ice Punch. But yeah, that was pretty much the plan for Gligar. Standard, Stealth, Rock Roots, Defog, Earthquake. My Christmas Spirit, Zatu, back. Looking at his team, Ribombee actually really went in, so I needed some sort of answer. I did not want Webs, so clearly Magic Bounce. I did not want Ribombee setting up, so Light Screen kind of neutralizes that. Psyshock, just to do damage, if because, you know, Quiver Dance, it boosts special attack, special defense, and speed. And if I'm hitting it with a regular special move, it's going to be eating that up. I'm just going to be setup fodder at that point. Honestly, I could have ran Toxic too, but like killing it, with a chance to 2-hit KO Ribombee with Psyshock is definitely worth it. I also have Luki's gym teacher back, surprisingly. Looking at his team, I didn't know what I was going to do for a lot of his mons. I didn't want stuff like Type Null or Gligar to do, basically, to do more than it needs to. If it eats a hit from maybe like Nihiligo, Zygarde will go in, like, and vice versa. So I kind of need something else to take a hit as well. And that was Girder. I pretty much brought a more bulkier offensive team. Well, not offensive, but like more bulkier team. And Girder eats up hits from Nihiligo really well, hence special defensive. It also eats up hits from Mega Gyarados, and it has the Drain Punch to get its health back. I'm bringing Rest Talk again with knockoff Drain Punch. You know, this time Iron Fist instead of Guts, like I did for last time. But yeah, I'll just get into the game. So I lead Zatu in case he leads Brabombi, because I don't want the webs or free setup turn. I get my light screen up. I honestly didn't know what he was going to do first turn, so I was playing it safe. And Psyshock really didn't do much. I go into type null because, well, reset there. I go into type null because I wasn't exactly sure at the time if I had a Dusknoir answer. I didn't really want knockoffs, so. And I saw Shadow Claw on my type null. I was like, alright, this is fine. I really would not prefer anything else to get knocked off on my team. So he Ice Punches. I get Frozen again. But like last week, I Thaw first turn and I get the Shadow Claw off. That did a 23 damage on Infernape. And I did not know what Infernape was going to be. So he clicks U-turn, goes into Brabombi, and I go back into Zatu. And here is when he sets up. Oh boy, set up Brabombi. So that Moonblast did 54. That did a lot. I had to get my screens up. Here he Quiver Dances again. I believe a Roost. And then here I go for Psyshock Spam, basically. I don't know. Brabombi here pretty much didn't do much after that. Another Psyshock. To be honest, I should have ran maybe Calm Mind on the Zatu instead of U-turn. But it did its work. Zatu did its work. It did the job that I needed Zatu to do. So Nihiligo goes in, and I go into Girder expecting to take a hit super well. I do take that Psychic, but I don't really take it well, to be honest. And bringing that Psychic was really smart prep for him, because I haven't been bringing Girder much. It's not really the star of my team. And him bringing Psychic was so smart for the Girder, because Girder actually eats up from the Nihiligo so well. And that gives me insight on how he likes to prep. It's pretty much similar to how I like to prep. And yeah, that was just mad props for that. Honestly, mad props for that. So I go for the rest because I did not want to bring this in to not take a hit from the Nihiligo next time. And I don't really have a switch in for Jirachi. So I go my type null. I could honestly Swords Dance up on this boy, but it's risky because he could just go into Infernape, right? Or something powerful like that. He gets up Rocks, I get up my Rest. He shows up with the Wish, so I know it's Rocks, Zen Headbutt, Wish, probably Iron Head, to be honest, because it's Jirachi, come on. And he goes into the Ape as I reveal the Swords Dance. I go into Zatu, planning to sack it off, to be honest. But, I mean, it lives on one, apparently. So, type null in, Dusknoir, not doing shit. I get another Swords Dance with my Sleep Talk, though, and he reveals the Destiny Bond. So, I calc this, and it did not kill. So, I was fine with that. And I know it's gonna drop, probably, and something coming in would take a big hit from Shadow Claw. So, here I was worried about what Infernape it would be. And judging from the U-turn damage to Manaphy, it was Bandit. I had no switch-ins to Bandit, so I kind of had to stay in, take my losses here. In case he wanted to U-turn or something, of course, right? Because I don't want him to have momentum. So I do the damage. I sack out Zatu here. I bring in Zerara in order to revenge kill. Had he brought in Zidog here, that would have been kind of scary, but he goes into Jirachi. He's probably going to make a wish here as I go into Gligar. And nothing really wants to take an Earthquake from my Gligar. So he starts Iron Head spamming. He reveals his full set. And honestly, this part gets kind of boring. He's trying to flinch me down. I'm trying to wear it down or wear down his whole team. He makes more wishes. Earthquake. Here he's going to make an obvious like Iron Head. He gets the wish health back. And I'm just honestly trying to not get flinched down by this, because this is so annoying. So I finally get the Rocks up for anything he wants to switch in, potential Sashes, all that good. And here, repeat again, Zen Headbutt miss, Earthquake, and was this the turn? And this was the turn I finally break free from Jirachi and kill it. And again, no real switch into Infernape, so I was like, damn, this is scary as heck. So I calc, Gligar lives one, surprisingly, and I honestly didn't care about close combats from an ape at that point. So I heal up, and Zygarde is scary. I heal up again, I believe, as he starts to set up. And honestly, set up Zygarde is one of the most scariest things ever. So I Earthquake again, and I switch out Sack the Null in case he wanted to Z-move. He went for Outrage, so I'm not sure if he had Z-move there, so I go back into Gligar as he clicks Outrage. I know Gligar lives all hits from Zygarde, barring the Z-move. I Earthquake, and here I could have just clicked Earthquake, but I was expecting to die, to be honest. And here I'm just Roost stalling for no reason, to be honest. I don't know why, because I forget Earthquake can actually Oko Nihiligo. But yeah, that was pretty much it. Good game to my boy EduRufus. I hope he bounces back. He's a good player. And dang, I just really brought it to him this week. Honestly, he has too many strong threats. Like, this boy's team is scary. But that about does it for week 6. Week 7, I have Orange and the Memphis Metagross. And that's going to be a volatile matchup. I don't know how that matchup's going to go. But again, his team is also scary. Honestly, everyone's team is freaking scary to go up against. I don't know how I'll do. I don't know how he'll do. But yeah, we'll leave it as a surprise. I'm already prepped. And you know, we'll just let it be. We'll show. I'll try to show up and give a good battle. But that about does it. Show some support. Leave a comment, because I love those comments. I love reading those comments. Leave a like, subscribe, and we out. Peace.